Vincent van Gogh, born in 1853, is perhaps the most famous artist in the world. Even though he only sold one painting in his lifetime, he's now an icon of the modern art world. He had a short career, but even in that short career, he has inspired other artists and revolutionized the art world. Today, we are going to take a look at one of his most famous pieces called Starry Night. He painted this scene from a room in a mental asylum where he was staying. It has a very dreamy look to it as he's looking down on the village at night. There's vibrant colors and twisting, spiraling lines. That swirling motion just kind of brings you in. Today, we're going to do our own version of Starry Night. First, we're going to use the wet-on-wet watercolor technique. So you're going to paint your paper with water first before you dip into the liquid watercolors. I'm going to give you purple, blue, and black paint today, and you can use them however you'd like to fill your page. No white space left when you're finished. After we've painted with the watercolors, we're going to sprinkle on a little bit of salt to give kind of a crystallized, starry look to the sky. This will be our background. Next up, we're going to be working on the village. So we're going to take a piece of black paper and a silver Sharpie, and we're going to start by making some hills and some buildings. I'm going to include a church and some houses in mine, just as the village we see in Starry Night. You want to try to make these three-dimensional, meaning after you draw that kind of basic house outline, you're going to draw lines going out from each point so that we have a more realistic looking house or building. I would suggest doing a little bit of practice first on a separate sheet of paper before you move on to your Sharpie. Starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils, catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. Starry. After you've drawn your buildings, you can also add some dashed lines in that swirling motion to kind of emulate the brush strokes that Vincent van Gogh used. Reflect in Vincent's eyes of china blue, colors changing hue. Morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now, for they could not love you, but still your love was true. And our last detail, we'll be using white paint to add more of that swirling motion to the sky. This was a big part of Starry Night, all of those stars and the moon and those swirly brush strokes. So I like to start with a few big swirls, the moon, a few large circles for stars, and then I go in afterwards and I add those dashed lines along the edges, again, to emulate those brush strokes that Vincent van Gogh used. What you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free, they would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never